Hello, my dear students. Welcome to our new session of social science class. In the previous classes, we studied about Europeans, their achievements, wars and legislations. The English, those who reached India for trade, became our masters for years. How was the reactions of Indians towards English East India Company, especially to their legislations? How the English East India Company behaved to Indians? How Indians showed their protest against company's exploitative measures? In the third chapter titled Resistance and the First War of Indian Independence, we can examine all these things. Okay. While we look around us, there are different ways of protest by different types of people. Why are they protesting? Have you seen any such protest of the people? I think all of you might have seen such situations in your life. It might be for to increase the best fare and salary, to decrease the working hours, for the resignation of any political leaders. So there are so many reasons for the protest of the people. If people feel that they have been exploited by others, they look for ways to resist it. This type of protest against exploitation started centuries before. For example, we can listen a story about the ways by which Nagodas protested against English East India Company. Nagodas were the sericulturists of Bengal. Sericulturists means those who breeding the silkworms. Weavers from different countries came to buy the silk produced by the Nagodas. When Bengal came under the control of English East India Company, the British people began to exploit the Nagodas. That is, Nagodas were compelled to do weaving for meager or low wages and denied the opportunity to find out any other occupations. They had no permission to find out any other occupations. Thus, they were the bonded laborers of the English East India Company. That is, Nagodas lived like slaves under the British. Those workers who were not willing to obey English East India Company were tortured. They had to suffer a lot. British seized their properties from them. British took their property legally as British government. Thus, Nagodas took a decision collectively that they would give up weaving, their traditional occupation, because it did not help them to earn a living or money to meet their daily needs. Hence, Nagodas decided to cut off their thumb as a protest against the policies of the English East India Company. This protest of Nagodas was not an isolated event or not an entirely different event. It was common practice to protest like this. English East India Company rule adversely affected farmers, weavers, craftsmen and tribals. All these workers who were engaged in traditional occupations were exploited by the British. Name the workers who were engaged in traditional occupations exploited by the British. They were the farmers, weavers, craftsmen and tribals. Have you underlined these points in your textbook? Okay. So now we can discuss how British exploited the farmers of Bengal. In the previous class, we have studied through Battle of Plassey and Battle of Buxar. English conquered the entire Bengal by seizing its agricultural prosperity and trade facilities. Okay. Then the attention of the company changed to exploit these resources to its maximum. That is, to exploit rich agricultural sector of Bengal. To exploit the resources of Bengal, English East India Company used five methods or five strategies. We can examine one by one of these strategies. The first strategy English East India Company used was that They imposed, levied heavy taxes on farmers. English East India Company levied high taxes on farmers. And second strategy was that no tax concessions were sanctioned even when drought and flood destroyed the agriculture. Whenever there is no water during the summer season, we call that period as a drought. So during the drought and flood time, the farmers didn't get any tax concession from the British rule. At present, we can see that governments are giving some concessions to the people to remit loans, taxes in their adverse situations. The third strategy was that these taxes were collected by the middlemen or zamindars. Middlemen means the person who are standing or acting in between people and a British government. And fourth strategy was that the farmers were expected to pay the tax in the form of cash. That was the condition the British imposed upon the people. The farmers had to depend on Sahus for loan at a high rate of interest. Sahus mean private money lenders. Those who are giving money to the common people, we call them as a private money lenders. So let us repeat the points once more. How British exploited the farmers of India. English East India Company levied heavy taxes on farmers. No tax concessions were sanctioned even when drought and flood destroyed the agriculture. Taxes were collected by the middlemen or zamindars. Farmers were expected to pay the tax in the form of cash. And lastly, the farmers had to depend on Sahus for loan at a high rate of interest. Usually, the farmers of Bengal used their fertile fields for cultivating food crops. But the British identified these fields of Bengal were much favorable for growing the cash crops or commercial crops like cotton, jute and indigo. British realized the fields of rich fields of Bengal very suitable for the cultivation of cotton, jute and indigo. We call these crops as a commercial crops or cash crops. Cotton is a raw material used for cotton clothes. And jute is a raw material for making different types of products which are very lasting one. And indigo is used for dyeing or giving color to the clothes. These three major raw materials, that is cotton, jute and indigo, which were needed by the British, and it was very essential for them to support their industries in England. Consequently, as a result, the British expanded the cultivation of cotton, jute and indigo and forced the farmers to do so. Now, the fertile fields of Bengal changed into the plantations of cotton, jute and indigo. The fertile fields of Bengal changed into plantations of cotton, jute and indigo. Plantation means cultivation in acres of land. Did you see such plantations like rubber plantation, tea plantation, etc.? So, because of this expansion, the farmers became landless and were forced to become laborers. These were the hardships faced by the farmers of Bengal under the company rule. But at present, farmers are getting more importance in our society. Nowadays, we are realizing their role in our day-to-day life. And we are also interested in agriculture. Is it so? Yes. Let us sum up what we discussed today. First, we studied about Nagoda's protest against the company rule. Then we studied different types of people who were exploited under the British rule. Then we studied a detailed study of the exploitation of the farmers by the English East India Company and its after effects. I expect all of you understand today's topic. Okay, thank you.